Good morning. In this particular video, we'll be discussing about the data exchange standard. So initially, here we'll discuss about the oldest and still utilized data exchange standard, IGES, will be discussed in this particular video. So we have already discussed about the need for utilizing data exchange standards in the previous videos. So if you draw a particular drawing of a particular solid model with utilizing a SolidWorks software, it is a necessity such that the same model has to be analyzed with the help of some analysis software such as ANSYS. So if you have to transfer the drawing you made in SolidWorks to ANSYS, what you need is you need a common file format which could be accessed by both the softwares. So such a necessity gave rise to the neutral file format known as IGES. Another one is STEP, but IGES is the oldest form and it is being still used in most of the cases. IGES is still used because of its simplicity. But of course, its efficiency is very much lesser compared to the next type, STEP. In this particular video, we'll be discussing about IGES data exchange standard. Okay, as we already discussed, the various data exchange standards available are IGES, STEP, DXF, CALS and all. Okay, so we'll start with IGES. So IGES stands for Initial Graphics Exchange Specification. So this is actually the oldest standard for data exchange, which has been the version 1, has been released in the year 1980. Of course, it is utilized to convert a CAD model into neutral file with the help of a inbuilt preprocessor which is available within the software itself. So here I could visualize this is the drawing which is made utilizing SolidWorks, and if you are going to save this particular part model in IGES format, various formats are available within your drawing itself. From the available format you could select IGES so that this drawing could be saved in a neutral IGES file format. So as I already said, this is the oldest one. That's the version 1 has been released in 1980. It has a peculiarity so that it has been released for over 40 years and still this has not been modified. No updation has been made on this particular file format, and that alone will remain as a major drawback of this particular data standard. Okay. So first of all, we'll just look into the IGES file structure, and the format is, again, as I already discussed, the coding is being done as per ASCII format, that is American Standard Code for Information Interchange format, and various sections which is available within the IGES file are flag section, stack section, global section, directory entry section, parameter data section and terminate section. So flag section, of course, we'll discuss it, these things in an elaborate way. The explanation is very much available, but I'll explain with the help of this flowchart. So flag section is actually, it's a header file for the IGES data. It's just a header file. Just like if you write the chapter heading, chapter 1 for a particular subject, of if you are studying CAD subject, you'll write chapter 1 or unit 1, introduction to CAD, likewise. So similarly, flag section is an introductory section, as it's a header file for the IGES file format. Next section is the start section and the global section. These two sections are actually combined one. This includes the pre-processing data of a particular drawing. For example, start section and global section, as I already said, includes the pre-processing data of a particular file. If you just look into this drawing is being made with the help of SolidWorks software. So that is a pre-processing data. This drawing is made by some individual. So his name, that could be a pre-processing data. So the version of the SolidWorks software used, the OS of the computer used, the system specifications, all those things are specified under start and global section. So it's actually, it's in a what? It will be appeared in a combined form. So we'll discuss that. Next section is known as directory entry section and parameter data section. Again, these two are almost similar. Directory entry section includes the code for the drawing. So if you just look into this drawing, these includes the major primitives which is being included are a circle is there, various lines are there, various curves might be there, square like shapes might be there, different shapes, arc might be there. So various shapes are available within this particular drawing, and these shapes will be coded within the directory entry section. And finally, the parameter data section arranges these codes. The codes which are available in the data entry section will be arranged in a continuous manner, such that first, if you draw the circle, that circle will be, the code of the circle be drawn will be mentioned initially, then that will be followed by another line, that will be followed by another square, that will be followed by another circle. The continuous manner of utilization of the entities or the primitives will be marked by means of this parameter data section. So these two includes similar data. The directory entry section includes the total list of the entities such as line, point, circle utilized, and the parameter data section includes the proper position, the proper dimension, and the order in which these entities have been utilized for drawing that particular component. And the final one is the terminate section, that means stopping the drawing. So finishing the drawing, that's the final section, that's terminate section. Okay, so these are the various regions in a IGES file structure. So the detailed explanation is available here. Okay, so these are the various entities with, or the primitives we could utilize within an IGES file format. So if you draw a circular arc, in this IGES file format, the circular arc will be converted as a code 100. A composite curve, that will be converted to a code 102. An arc, a conic arc, will be converted to a code 104. Again, a copies data 106, plane 108, line 110. Likewise, your drawing, the drawing you make in the software, you'll use the icons and all. If you can use the line icon, you'll draw the line. Again, you can use the circle icon, you'll draw the circle. So that drawing will be created in the software. The graphical user interface will show you the drawing, but this drawing will be saved in IGES file format in this, but in these type of codes, such as this 100, 102, 130, 164. Likewise, these various codes are actually utilized to save each and every entities you have drawn in the particular drawing. Okay, so for example, this is a simple drawing. It considers two lines. These green lines, the lines are of green color, two arcs of pink color, and two points, these two markers of some might be red, some light red color. So these are the three different entities which you have utilized for drawing this particular image. So here, these lines are coded as 110. These circular arcs are coded as 100. These two points are coded as 116. So that is how an IGES file format will save your drawing. Of course, this line alone is 110. The color of line, that requires another coding. The position of the line, the dimension of the line, all those things require another coding, and that could be visualized in the parameter data section. And these entities will be available in the directory entry section. So we'll just look an example. This is an example for a bolt. It's a hexagonal head which is being drawn with the help of any software. It includes thread. So if you just look into it, this is actually the start section, PTCIGS file. So this is the start section. So something above this will be the flag section. That will initiate the conversion. So that could be the name which you could give for the particular drawing. That is the flag section. This is the start section. You could just see the coding. The S stands for start section. And the remaining data, the preprocessor data, the data which specifies the software you have utilized for drawing this image, the place in which you have utilized, the IP address, all those things, the preprocessor data will be available in the global section. And this is the directory entry section. This directory entry section includes the various primitives you have utilized for the drawing. So these are the various entities you have utilized for the drawing. So that will be listed along the directory entry section. And this means the termination of your drawing. So a more clear example could be visualized here. This is a simple drawing, AutoCAD 3D. So this drawing has been made in, has been converted in IGS file format. So here, this is the start section. S stands for the start section. And this includes the global section. So this actually includes the data, the pre-processing data, the place, the software, the place, the person whom drew the drawing. So all those things will be included in this particular data. So next one, this is actually the global section. G stands for the global section. S stands for the start section. So again, these include the directory entry region, the entities you have utilized for drawing this image. These are the directory entry section includes that. Again, this section is actually the parametric data entry section. So this shows the arranged order in which your particular drawing is being made. And the final one, the T stands for termination, stop. That is the end of the drawing. So these are the various sections that could be visualized in a IGES file format. Okay. Then, so that's all about IGES. That's all about the explanation required for IGES. Now we'll just look into some of the drawbacks of IGES. As I already said, this is the oldest format and is still the oldest since there is no updation available for that. So that's a major drawback. It is not as it's not an information rich as solid geometry. So of course, so this data is not similar to a solid geometry which we could create with the help of a software. This is actually a coded file. A drawing is being coded into some other file. So why it is not information rich? Because a solid model will include a lot of dimensions. This geometric and dimensional tolerance will be marked on that. So likewise, because of that, this geometric and dimensional tolerances will be marked on the drawing. But if you just look into the same file, the same drawing, if you just convert it to an IGES file and all, this data could not be available there. That is, IGES cannot carry MBD, that is model based geometry, not mode based. It is model based geometry, or PMI data, that is product and manufacturing information. So it doesn't take with it the geometric and dimensional tolerancing or the manufacturing operations, whether it is flat, whether it is parallel, that flatness, parallelism, roundness, all those geometric features might not be available within the IGES file format. Again, another major drawback is it often needs to be repaired. Of course, some conversion errors are often faced while you convert a drawing into an IGES format. So these are the major drawbacks which is being faced while utilizing an IGES standard. So these disadvantages could be overcome by utilizing STEP file format. So we'll discuss STEP file format in the next video. Thank you.